What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another Logic Pro X quick tip tutorial. I am Clormo, and today I want to show you a little bit about pitch bending, shifting hi-hats with the MIDI automation tool in the piano roll of Logic Pro. This is, I think, a very useful tool that I haven't seen covered too much in YouTube tutorials before. So I just want to give you a different option to pitch bend your hi-hats and a different perspective. I think it has some advantages to it and it's simple to use. So again, just another alternative to those that want to use a specific instrument to just put different notes and have your pitch control that way. So this is going to be a quick video. Let's just go into Logic Pro X. I have here a stock instrument or 808 with a boring hi-hat and snare pattern. Let's just take a listen to that. The first thing we're gonna do, just make sure the region selected, press P in your keyboard to be in the piano roll. You can see here that I have my trap patterns or syncopated hat patterns with my region selected and my piano roll active. I'm gonna press A on my keyboard, or I can also use bottom over here, which shows and hides automation. It's there. I don't see anything obviously down here because I haven't drawn it. I have to draw it. By default, you're gonna see your volume, but you can just go into this list and select whatever the hell you want, pretty much, but we're gonna do the pitch bend. And now I just wanna put a point in there, wanna keep that at zero, and just take a listen to that. There's no pitch bending going on, right? It's at zero, so my pitch is not being altered. But let's say that I just wanna concentrate my bending on those little patterns there, those wrap patterns. I just create more points in there. So a few more points. And you might be saying, oh my God, I'm doing more, but you're gonna see why this is good too. It's a good option. And now once you have like that bounded where you wanna go, then inside you could put more points, move the curves around, and it's gonna give you a pitch bend. You can also draw in real time with your pencil tool. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put some points in here. I realize that I screwed that up. And let's see, let's make it like that. Then this example, I'm just gonna ramp it up, like a ramp up pattern. And then here, I just wanna go like an up and down. I'm gonna make it very extreme. So I'm going like from little to more to extreme. And let's just take a listen to what that did. And that way you can only have one track with one set of notes. Obviously I have my snare in here as well. This is just to show you what it, you know, how to do it. But ideally you want to have a track with the different parts, right? So you're going to have your hats here and you don't have to go up and down and then change the velocity. You can do all of that in here with the automation. Like I can also go here, note velocity, and I can change my velocities. Let's say, let's make this snare extreme, let's make this lower, and that's it. You know, that's what you do to put some automation there. Of course you want to make sure that you fine-tune it, you have more detailed control over it as just going from one note to the other up and down the scale. And then last but not least, like if I take that, you can see the gray bars are the automation information. I press Command R and I can keep repeating those around in my track, and then I can again come here and even give more variation to those automation parameters for the bend or the velocity or whatever else you choose to, and have more variation around your track overall. So I think that's very useful. That's something that's easy to do, and in my opinion, takes less time than trying to set up different instruments with different samples and doing that type of thing, which is not bad to do. I'm just saying this is just another option. So quick reminder, if you found value in this video, can you please help me by subscribing to my channel, Clormo, sharing it with other people, commenting if you have other ideas or ways to do pitch bending that I may not know about and want to share. Leave me a comment below, and also pay me a visit to clormoindustries.com if you want to stay up to date with everything else I'm doing. I'll leave you for now. See you in the next one. Peace out, people.